Hello everyone. In this session, I'm going to discuss about some basic idea of error detection and error correction. So what is meant by error detection or correction, and in which layer this occurs? Any idea? Okay. So error detection or correction will be required to check the errors in the receiver side. That means during the transmission, due to some reason, there will be errors in the bits that has been transmitted. That is the duty of the receiver to check there are errors occurred in the received data or not. If there are errors occurred, then the data will be considered as corrupted data and it will be discarded. What is meant by error correction? Error correction is detecting the error and correcting those errors. To compare error detection and error correction, which can be the most difficult one? Can you guess? Yes, that is error correction, because detecting the error and discarding the data will be easier. But whereas checking the error and finding out where the error has occurred, in which bit error has occurred, and also correcting that error, that is the challenging work. And this error detection and correction mostly happen in the data link layer. One of the method of error detection is block coding technique. In block coding, the original message is divided into different blocks, and each block will be having some extra bits added to that. So that extra bit is called as redundancy. So each block is called as a data word here, and each data word will be added with the redundant bits. After adding this redundant bit, it is called as a code word. So there are methods to convert the data word into code word in block coding technique. This code word will be transmitted to the receiver. The receiver will check the code word using some checking technique. Here we call that the resultant of the checking method as syndrome. If the syndrome is zero, it is considered as there are no errors, so original data is accepted. If the syndrome is non-zero, then the original data is considered as corrupted data. Hence, the data, whatever received in the receiver, will be discarded. I would like to show this with a small example. Let me consider these red blocks as the original data words. Consider this as original data words. I told you there are some redundant bits added for each data word. So this data word or blocks. So this is the original message, suppose. This is the complete message. Here, this message is divided into blocks. So I have three blocks here. Considering three blocks, for each block, redundant bits are added. Let me take redundant bits as blue colored one. As you see here, blue color one is attached. This is the redundant bit here. So for one more block, I'm going to add redundant bit. You can see now two code words. See why I told this as code word? A data word, this is data word, is added with the redundant bit together is called as a code word. And there are some methodologies to add this redundant bits. It is not added as it is. So there will be some methodologies to add this redundant bits. So you can see there are two code words. Let me consider one code word now. Suppose this is received in the receiver. Now, applying the checking methodology to this complete code word, we will get the syndrome as the resultant. If syndrome is equal to zero, then the original data word is extracted. That means it is accepted. If the syndrome is non-zero, then it is discarded. Basically, two types of error detection techniques are used. First one is parity check coding. Second one is cyclic redundancy check. In the error correction methodology, FEC, that is forward error correction, there are different methodologies used in the forward error correction. One more type of error detection technique is there, that is checksum. So for longer messages, we use checksum methodology.
Checksum methodology is used in the transport layer and network layer rather than data link layer.